guys. We had a little bit of a mix-up with the stream, but to quick recap for the Bears there, they won the first round, keeping the enemy team from even getting a single percentage on the capture point. Just had a little bit of a technical mix-up there, so my apologies.
Five, four, three, two, one. Attackers incoming. Defend objective A.
Alrighty, so the Bears will have to attack the point now, getting a lot further than what the enemy team did to begin with, so this will be interesting to see if they can get onto the point a lot quicker, which they do, but they lose TJ in the process. So that's a Reaper down, but some decent damage dealt by him before he went down, but quickly healed back by the enemy Zenyatta. This time the enemy team taking a similar approach to what LR did and trying to keep them within the underbridge choke point there, as looks like Deku and Badger are going to be leading the front here for the Bears. Let's just take a quick peek from their perspective what they're going to see as they come out. So they push out very well as a team, very well coordinated, take care of the enemy Rein. I'm sorry, that's a friendly Rein that goes down, as the enemy team falls back to the point to try to prevent any sort of collateral damage. The enemy Rein goes down, as does the enemy... I believe that was an enemy Ana that was down until just now, when I believe the Mercy revived her. So this will be quite interesting to see. So friendly Lucio goes down, as Badger and Deku just putting in work, trying to focus that Rein, trying to take care of that Rein before the Mercy gets her revive back, which they do. They're getting onto the point, about to capture the first point, and they do capture the first section, so Lenore Rein wins this round. And that'll be map one to the Bears, with play of the game coming from Dark Bones as McCree.
It's high noon.
Alrighty, and we'll get ready to move on to the second map of the set for the LR Bears, having a lead 1-0 over the enemy team. Alrighty.
Now arriving at Lijiang Tower. Initiating match. Ready for battle.
Alrighty, 25 seconds here as both teams prepare to attack. Badger informing the other team of our technical issues that I'm sure all of you experienced as well as us. We had no clue that our stream was actually being streamed by one of the LR Bears on his personal screen.
Five,
so
four, three,
that's an interesting problem to have, I guess.
One.
Alrighty, so the map is underway as both teams make their way out of the spawn and actually to opposite sides. So this will be interesting as they meet in the middle here. Let's take a quick peek. looks like the friendly Ryan goes down to begin with his taking enemy. Peek at the enemy team's back line there as they push forward onto the site. Let me take another peek at the objective. It's kind of crazy looking at it from this perspective, so let's just switch over to some first person. Alright, so looks like a couple of four kills actually for the Bears as they try to get on the point and get first percentage here. Five kills now. Very well done by the Bears there to get onto the point and get the first percentage going. Pretty much the same lineup again for the Bears this time. Already two ults for the Bears as well, which is very useful when you can get your ult early in the game very quickly. Lucio doing some group healing there as Vinny, what appears to be focusing on trying to keep the Lucio healthy or maybe just trying to heal whoever needs it. So we take a quick peek at TJ as Reaper. Alrighty, pretty nice execution by the Bears there to quickly take out three, close to four of the enemy team. So we switch over to Dark Bones in the back as McCree just kind of dealing some damage from behind. As the Bears consistently rack up some percentage points and get close to 50% as they push up into the spawn to keep the enemy team from even getting close to the point, and they do. They wipe out two of the enemy team, and we'll switch back to third person here as we navigate our way back to the point. Very well executed by the Bears, I must say, to prevent any loss of life and to very efficiently push back the team, the enemy team, before they even had a chance to really make a difference. Alright, both meeting here at the steps as the enemy Zarya gets by and tries to get on the flank there, as does D.Va and Ryan. So the enemy team rocking with, what, three tanks right now and three healers, okay. As the enemy team takes control of a point here and attempts to catch up to the Bears 83%. Now, as this is a control map, it's nobody's game. I'm sorry, it's anybody's game until one team reaches 100%. Doesn't matter if you're at 99%. You can get on that point, capture it, and hold it until the enemy team, until you reach 100 and preventing the enemy team from getting anything, then obviously you win. That's kind of how it works. Bears pushing up once more on the right side here, trying to stay active in the push, prevent the enemy team from getting any sort of momentum going for them. And this worked well for them last time, I must say. Last time they did this, they wiped out three people very quickly and were able to get onto the site. But looks like this time they decide to fall back as they lose Reinhardt and maybe try to regroup, use their percentage advantage, and make sure that they get onto the point and they can hold the point for the remaining 17% that they need to win the game. So Badger and Deku leading the front here, the Reinhardt and Zarya that is, with TJ trying to slide in behind, and he successfully does not do that. As they quickly lose Boop, Deku, and Badger, so that's going to be two tanks and a healer down, as once again the Bears are taking their time, playing it smart, trying to get onto the point as quickly as they can. They don't really have much more percentage to work with, so will they take a different route this time perhaps? It appears that they are going to try to sneak in on the backside here, and the enemy team picks up on it, regroups, going to meet them here at this doorway as we fall back and try to get a better perspective. Bears look like they are able to get onto the point very quickly there. And we'll take a quick peek at the action through the window here. That's the enemy Lucio down, enemy Reinhardt down, but a friendly Reaper down. But that's not too much of a loss since you still have your tanks and your healers down, so you can at least withstand your stance on the point. If they can just get this enemy D.Va off the point, they can recapture it and hopefully gain some momentum. They do get the D.Va off the point. Overtime will withstand, and now the Bears control the point and will attempt to push back the enemy team. Now at this point, like I said before, this is anybody's game. The enemy team is at 99%, just like I said, and the Bears have a solid chance at winning this game if they can prevent the enemy team from getting on the point in the next 5 seconds. And the enemy team did manage to sneak in there at the last second to get onto the point and force an overtime. So this will be a matter of numbers here, with the enemy team loses that very quickly, losing two people right off the bat. Over time winding down as the Bears try to push them back, and they do successfully hold off the other team, and the objective is secured, the Bears winning round one. Alrighty, and here we go, preparing for round two.
Five, four,
three, two, one. See if we can try to get a decent angle here. As you see, the Bears pushing up from that angle, and the enemy team pushing up from this angle. So, you know what, let's just sit right here and see what happens. Looks like both teams reached the point about the same time, so nobody's going to get that early advantage of getting on the point first, but the point hasn't even unlocked yet, so that's not really a big deal. It's just a matter of how many people can die at this point. So they get the enemy team's Lucio down, which is a big hit. They also get the enemy team's Moira down, so two healers down for the enemy team very quickly. And the Bears are going to capture the point first, keep them in the choke point here at the end of the hallway. And if they can deal with this D.Va on the right flank, they might be in good positioning. And they actually target the Brigitte and the Rhine, leaving just the D.Va so they can focus her, take her out, and now push up and try to make sure that they get another significant percentage advantage like they did last round. Deku leading the way here, probably going to pop that shield and try to push him back with the Zarya bubble on him. Let's take a little bit of a lower angle look right here. Oh yeah, enemy team trying to get in there and just deal some collateral damage, but quickly the Mei wall basically cuts the enemy team in half, allowing them to focus on the two that make it through. The Moira ult focusing there on the Lucio takes out the Lucio, takes out the D.Va, takes out the Zarya, and the Bears maintain control here, nearing 50%. Let's back up a little bit here as they're going to probably push back into this room. As the Bears reach 50%, continue to hold them back out of this room. If they try to use that Mei wall once more and separate this team in half, I'm not really sure how the other team will handle it. Okay, so this time instead, they decide to push out as a team to make sure they don't get separated. But the Bears handle it well, not losing anyone yet. The heal's coming in really clutch right now for the enemy for the Bears, preventing the enemy team from getting any sort of kills. So I must say that Boop and Vinny are doing a great job on the heals right now. Couple of ults down for the enemy team, and the Bears survive it, wipe out four of the enemy team, and it looks like the Bears might actually, knock on wood, sweep this one if they can hold off one more push. Nearing 90% before they interact with the enemy team any longer, as the Mei wall prevents them from getting out of the spawn until close to 95%. The Bears will look to, oh, and the Mei wall is going to keep them from getting onto the point, so that's good. They just, oh, they actually had someone sneaking behind. Okay. Wow. Even I got blocked by the Mei wall. Look at that. Look, Bears will once more try to isolate 1v1 fights here, maybe even 2v1 fights. Just try to pick off each person as best they can, because they've already got three people down. If they let the enemy team hold this here when they have numbers, that could be bad. Looks like they're just trying to take care of the Lucio, and the Lucio is doing an excellent job at avoiding right now. And the Lucio does go down, and very quickly overtime is over, and the Bears will win the second map. 2-0 for the Bears, and that is a win in game two of the three-game series of this evening. Play of the game going to Deku as Reinhardt, so let's take a quick look at that before we take a preview into what's going to happen for the rest of the evening. Very nice win for the Bears there as they go 2-0, two maps to none on the enemy team there. Alright, so far on the evening, the Bears have managed to go 1-1, that is a solid 500, so they will look to go above 500 in this third game, starting at, I believe, 8:30. Let me check with my technical advisor here and make sure that that is the correct time, and If that is, then we'll see you shortly. Alrighty, so it does look like the third game of the evening for the Bears is going to be at 8:30 p.m. Eastern Time, 5:30 Pacific Time, Pacific Standard Time, that is. So if you guys will just tune back in roughly an hour and 20 minutes, and we'll see you then. Alrighty, go Bears.